The only people who come are the ones who are desperate. So for them, the experience is one in which they end up leaving their therapies, they end up starting a process of discovering themselves. It's very rewarding at that level.
System. The human design system is a synthesis of global information, of global systems, both ancient and modern. And through this synthesis, we have an accurate way of detailing the nature of what you are as a mechanism. In other words, the basic mechanics of how you function in the Maya.
In other words, the human design system is a way to know yourself.
It's a way to accurately know who you are. The only thing that you can ever tell the public about the human design system is come and find out what it's about.
I mean, I'm not a moralist. Either is the human design system. Nobody's to blame for what they are. And most human beings have suffered great indignities in their life through the effects of conditioning that they're totally unaware of. What design really shows people in a simple way, whether you're a child or an adult, is to simply be able to point out and say, look, you can either trust your emotions or not. And if you can't trust those emotions, then be aware that every time you're emotional, you can see who and what is affecting you emotionally, because it's coming from outside, it's coming from somebody else. We can show people what awareness to trust. If you can't trust your mind, don't trust it. It's going to get you into a lot of trouble. You know, if you can trust your instinct, trust it. So what we show people is what is reliable within their nature and where they are vulnerable. Now, that's a great value to people. It's an enormous value to human beings.
How does it typically change their lives?
That's cute. You know, life changes. Nobody changes their life. What happens to them is that they have a window of awareness that's available to them. There is nothing in this life but what some people call luck. Of the thousands of people that I've worked with, there are some people who grasp it deeply and who are moved by it and find a way to incorporate that into a whole new way of being. But, you know, one of the things that I don't do and I'm very clear about is that the human design system offers no promise of anything. We're not selling a promise here. It's not the enlightenment road. You know, this is not, say, 25 mantras, everything's going to be okay. This is a very cold, clear, logical, analytical way in which a human being can see themselves and begin whatever their own unique process is to come out of that. The one thing I do know, 7 years. It takes 7 years. 7 years of working with it to be able to be free of the conditioning.
One of the major things that I learned from it was that how I am affected by other people, other relationships with people.
Sure, it's one of the most important aspects. You see, I'm an Aries with double rat. I'm here to plant seeds. I will never see in my lifetime even the beginning of this tree or any of its fruit. It's a long ways away. This is new knowledge, and it's a profound revelation that came into the world that really is for real. What it does for human beings is for real. But it's going to take a very, very long time for that to flower. You see, everything that I represent goes against the standards that are accepted in our society, that there is such a thing as free will, that there is moral redemption, that there are all these things that simply have nothing to do with what I know is the reality of our Maya, if I can put those two juxtaposed together.
With Maya, you mean the illusion we live in?
Yes, the illusion we live in, which is very beautiful. Eh? It's warm, it's nice, we all like it, but nonetheless, it's an illusion. And the assumption that we are in control of our lives, this is one of the most painful aspects of the illusion. I deal with nothing but expectation in this life. Human beings are just into it.
You often say, no choice.
Yes, I wear it on my chest inside here.
It is your shirt, your t-shirt. Yeah. No choice.
No choice.
How does that relate to what you said? There is no free will.
Okay, let me put it in a way that perhaps is easier to understand. If you're all alone, if you're totally all alone, I mean truly all alone, the only thing that you can know, what Nisargadatta knew, is that you can know I am. That's truly all you can know if you're alone. You can know I am. And if you're all alone and suddenly there's light around you and you can see the shapes of things, there's a possibility of being able to say, I know I am here now. That's all very possible. There's no Maya in any of that. This is the spontaneous existential reality. I am here now. But the moment that you meet another, in that moment something enters in and it's called the Maya. Because you see, we're here to explain things to each other. This is one of our jokes. And in order to explain things to each other, we need to have words. And the moment we have words, we have reasons. So I say, I am here now, and you say, why? And I say, because. And I say, because of this and because of that. Now that's the Maya.
And
now
that's when you say mutual projections and games happen.
They just happen. Everything happens. Life happens.
And your dehuman design system then helps you to dissect the Maya, the illusion, the games.
That's what it's for.
Exchanges from what might be the underlying reality.
It is the mechanics of the Maya. This year, I was lucky enough to have a couple of books come through me, and one of them is called Rave Anatomy, The Mechanics of the Maya, and it's simply a mapping of the Maya. The body graph, the human design body graph, the rave body graph is an international symbol that one day will act as a language. I have students from all over the world, and we can all stand together and look at a body graph on a wall, and we can all speak that language without ever having to say a word to each other. We all have a common language to work with. That's the future. You see, human beings are going to ultimately have to find the best way to organize each other and come together. In the work that I do with corporations, one of the most fantastic things is you can really see how you can maximize potential at any level simply by bringing the right people together. This is one of the most valuable tools of design, is to really see the nature of human compatibility, and at a level that's very profound.
You mean you could help make teams work better?
Oh, much better.
Or you could people that function...
One day the planet will function better that way.
Hopefully.
Not hopefully, it will.
People that function in a specific way, you could analyze what their shortcomings are.
Let me give you an example. Let's say that you have three people that are working in an office space in a corporation. They have exactly the same job. They get exactly the same salary. There is no functional difference between them. Okay. And one of them has a defined channel. What I mean by defined is within their circuitry, something that's always operating. And that channel happens to be the channel of leadership, the design of an alpha. So by their very nature, they need to exert their influence. It's not their fault. It's not like there's something wrong with them. It's not like they want to be the boss or they have to be the boss. They just happen to be the boss. So here are these three people in this office working together, doing the same job for the same money, but one of them is always pushing around the others. One of them is always trying to be the leader. One of them is always trying to be the boss. Now that's going to generate problems. Now by looking at that situation, we can see that that person belongs in a position where they can exert that energy naturally, in which the response to that energy is correct. In other words, they need to be in a position of authority, not to be in the same place with people doing the same job where they end up being the enemy. It's a simple thing. But in this way, you can organize organizations so that everybody really gets along with the people that they're working with. It's one of the keys.
In more specifics, you have a relation. You are in a relationship with a certain person, and there is always this fight going on, this nagging. Are there ways to overcome that?
Yes and no. Yes and no. It's like anything else. Everything is about awareness. If you're unaware, nothing's possible. Ignorance is the great evil of the world. If you're aware, anything is possible.
Yeah, but this specific situation...
Well, for example, there are people that have a channel which is called the channel of judgment. It's a channel of insatiability. They're never satisfied. And these are people that have a deep critical potential. Now, we need them, but they bitch all the time. So if you have somebody like that working with you, there's two things to recognize. One is that their ability to recognize what needs correction in the moment is accurate, but at the same time, it's a pain in the neck. So you have to value that out. Is the information more valuable than the frustration of having to deal with them? You cannot change them. You see, this is the beauty about design. I'm an individual. I know that I cannot survive in the world unless I accept everybody else.
But you can at least come to the point to say, it is not because you are bad or you are...
Exactly. In other words...
It's because you are who you are.
That worker can see that's the kind of person they are. It's not personal. They're not bitching about me. That's just their mechanism. That's what they do.